What is up, everybody? CircleFlex is here with another Q&A. I have no clue what number we're at. It might be 5, might be 6. I think it's 6, because the guy in the comments says it's 6. Fuck my life. So, Daniel Grabowski, I probably pronounced that completely correct. Not a single issue there. Since I'm noticing a general trend, win rates going down. Even my unicorn friends with win rates have dropped below 48%. What do you think? Why do you think this is happening? I'm on the NA server and everybody complains about constant losses. What? I'm recording this on Tuesday, obviously. I had a win rate of 88% on Friday playing the tier 6s, the Cromwell. 88% in 7 hours. So, yeah, I think it's a you problem. Not an us problem. Just a bit of bad luck, man. Just play some comfortable tanks if you're that bored by win rates, man. Seriously, play a Cromwell and come back with less than 60% win rate. I'll be surprised. The tired Bobcat 622222 says, if you were able to play one tank just one more time, it was removed from the game, what would it be? Well, I don't think a lot of tanks get removed from the game, so I'm gonna answer it in a different way. there's a couple of tanks that you cannot get any longer, but people can still play them. Like the Alien, for example, or what is it, like an 820 or something, like some tier 4 Russian light. But the one tank I want to play and that I really would love to have, but I don't think I'll ever be able to get it, is the Panzer 5-4. Now you might be wondering, Circum, what the fuck is that? I only know Panzer 4-5s and stuff like that. The Panzer 5-4, it's by now, it's like a tier 5 light. I think it is. Let me just hop on the thanks to GG here. Let's see. See if I can find it real quick. Oh, it might still be tier 6. Or I could just not show up and take the G at all. What the fuck? Oh, it might be classified as a medium, huh? Yes, it's a medium. So it's a tier 5 medium. See if I can bring it up on the video here. So it's this thing. you can see it on screen right now. So the Panzer 5-4. It's a tier 5 now. It used to be tier 6. And it's not... It's pretty horrible. It's not that good at all. But it has limited matchmaking now as well. It got buffed like 2 patches ago out of like nowhere. So it's kind of interesting. It has a really still, it just has like the regular tier 5 gun that the tier 4, that the normal tier 5s get. But it's on a Panther chassis with a Panzer 4 turret, which means you can ram things. And it looks glorious. For those who don't know, I really love how everything looks. About Panthers. Panther tanks look amazing to me. I think they're like one of the coolest designs of the Second World War. And anything on a Panther chassis, I'm like, yes, I want it! I want it now! So, I would love for some way to get this. But the only way you could get it is by pre-ordering World of Tanks, basically. And this was the medium package. And then the largest package, which is like $100 or something, was the Alien tank in tier 8. I would also like an Alien tank, but the Panzer 5-4 is such a fucking odd one out. It's not even really a good tank. I would love it. Just give it to me. It's like the Nikolai and Riddle Warships. I would love, absolutely love a Nikolai and Riddle Warships. But, you know, I don't... Well, the Nikolai, I might have some chance, because that was not a pre-order. So, maybe they'll sell it. I don't know. So, at the Rakikala says, what's... keeps you still playing this game? Mostly you guys playing any game for, I don't know, there might be like one or two of you that are, you know, listening in that actually live stream themselves or produce some YouTube content or something. It's an extremely different world, an extremely different experience of playing the game, and it's like a thousand times as fun playing it on stream. If I wasn't streaming it, or if I never did stream it, I would probably still play the game. I would just would have played it way less than I have, therefore kind of still be interested in the game because I haven't played it as much. If I would play this much, but I wouldn't make content for it, I probably wouldn't do that. Like, I probably would get bored because I played this game well, a lot. And some people even play more than me and they don't produce any content, and I don't know how they do it. Sometimes I kind of wish, you know, I could go back to playing that way, because, like, I used to play, like, I literally, like, I don't really give a fuck about stats, but then back then it was just like, fuck it. You know, I could play whatever. And now, if I play, like, a Type 59 or something, or like, you know, some really good tank, that some people say, like, say, like, I really I despise how good an E5 is now, right? I think it's overly buffed and stuff like that, but say there's a tank that you guys hate just as much as D5, and I keep playing it because I like it. And then people in chat are always like, oh, stop fucking playing this OP tank or something like that, you know what I mean? And if I play on my own, you know, if I never streamed this game, I could just play whatever the fuck I like 24/7. And nowadays, I kind of have to, like, you know, free mark some things and stuff like that to keep things fresh. So, basically, what still keeps me playing this game is just you guys, the community around it, having the chat tune in, you know, see people being really happy about things in the chat. Just, you know, really makes my day. It's really awesome. What's your biggest regret in World of Tanks? Every single game outside of the Bird that I played in Artillery. Fuck off. fuck Artillery, man. Fuck anybody who plays it. Thomas the Dank Engine. That's a nice name you got there, Sunny Boy Jim. So, Sir God, if you ever played Command & Conquer, heard some of your songs in your streams. Yes! I remember fondly when I was in, like, well, I don't know what to call this, like, in the Netherlands, it was, like, Groep 3? The Dutch people will know. I don't know how old I was. I was, like, what, 6, 7, 8? I don't know, dude. I think it was 6, maybe 7. And I remember playing at a friend's house. He had Command and Conquer, the first one. And we played it on his dad's PC. That made a lot of noise. And that was a whole lot of fun. I remember drawing the turrets. That's really weird. But the turrets were basically a square with a triangle in it. And a little stick sticking out. Those were like the GDI turrets. I drew those at school. And so, I don't know. I'm fucking weird, okay? Then, at another friend's place later on in life, I played Command & Conquer Red Alert on the PlayStation 1, because I didn't really have a PC at all for the longest time. So I played Red Alert 1 myself. And then at another friend's house, Red Alert 2 came out, and I spent almost every day for like a month going to his house in the evening and then playing till like 10 o'clock or something. And then we played like Red Alert 2, or I just watched him play Red Alert 2. And it was the most amazing thing ever. And then after that, it was still like Generals, and I kind of played it, but like Red Alert 2 for me is the best one. And with Jewish Revenge, like, I love the fucking graphics, I love the UI, I love everything about it. I freaking love the music. The music is one of the best things about Command & Conquer with, you know, I kind of forgot his name right now, it's kind of horrible. Same guy made all the OSTs for like all the first ones. I don't know if he did the later ones, I don't think so. So good, man. So good. So yeah, I did play Command & Conquer. I would love to play like a Red Alert 2 on the PC again. I would love to stream it even. But right now, there's like a lot of weird shit going on to be able to play it. I would just like a Red Alert 2 HD. That just needs to happen. Basically. Anyway, those were the 5 questions for today. Thank you guys for tuning in as always. Hope to catch you guys on the stream. Links are all down below. Schedule's down below if you're interested in catching me live during the week. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.